Hi guys, welcome to a new video. Today I am going to be reviewing and testing out Milk Makeup Blur Stick. This is something I wanted to try out for a long time actually, and I've been putting it off and putting it off and putting it off because number one, it's not the cheapest product out there, and number two, I thought it was going to be like a gimmicky product. I didn't know what to expect, so I was like, eh, I'll put it off. But finally, I decided to do this video and hence me purchasing this product. Now this is a mini of the actual size, so if you're looking at this and you're like on, you know, whatever website and you're seeing the price tag, this is not the full size. I do have the 0.19 ounces and I purchased this for $14, so this is kind of like a trial size. You can get the 1 ounce for $36, so this is not the $36 size. That one is like a lot bigger. So let me just read you my notes really quickly and just kind of tell you what this product is all about. It is a silicone-free, oil-free matte primer stick that glides on sheer to blur pores and fine lines. So this is like smoothing, texture, pore line minimizing product, which I could definitely use because number one, I have acne prone oily skin, I have large pores, I have lines including smile lines, so I just have a bunch of texture issues that I would love to conceal and cover up. Not that there's anything wrong with any of that, you know, we don't want to be too harsh on ourselves here, but if there's something that we can do to kind of like minimize all that stuff, then why not? I also want to say that besides just kind of like covering things up, I do try to focus on my skincare as well. But you know, there's nothing wrong with trying something like this out. Okay, and then I also want to say this is cruelty-free, paraben-free, vegan, silicone-free, dimethicone-free, oil-free, gluten-free, soy-free, and talc-free. So if you know, if you're looking for it to be some things free, then it's a lot of things free. What does it have in it? No, I'm just kidding. So I saw that it's dimethicone-free and oil-free. I think those things tend to clog pores, so if you are acne-prone, then this is a good thing. Not to say that this is not going to clog your pores, but for me it's always like, oh great, it's oil free and it's dimethicone free. Dimethicone I think is the ingredient that actually makes everything like super gorgeous on the skin, like it smooths everything out, but then again it also clogs pores really badly I think, so that's a good thing. This is the packaging right here really quickly, which I think is actually quite cute, but also that's the reason I thought it was going to be a gimmicky product is because of the packaging. It is a twist product. I don't want to twist it out because I don't want it to like, you know, get everywhere, but like you can twist this thing and it comes out. It is a solid stick and it is this kind of like a beigey color. So if you have either like a lighter color or a darker color, I wouldn't worry about the color of this product because when it goes on the skin, it's pretty much clear. It is a weirder formula and I know I have tried to describe the formula in the next segment when I was applying it, but I did not do the best job, and that's because it is a creamy formula when you apply it on the skin, like it feels like a cream product, but it's a little bit more like solid than that because it is a solid stick. However, when you actually like feel it on the skin, it's not cream at all. It's more like a slightly powdery, velvety finish, and it feels like there's almost nothing on the skin. It's the weirdest texture to me, like just it does not make any sense. I don't know how it works, but maybe magic. Without further ado, let's jump into the next section where I apply this on the skin. I'm going to be doing half face comparison and also I'm going to be doing updates throughout the day to show you how it lasts on the skin. This does have like a weird application feel. It kind of feels like matte creamy but thick stick. I'm gonna apply it on my nose as well. I know I'm doing like a half face comparison, but I'm gonna apply it on my nose because I don't divide my nose evenly. I'm gonna apply this on my crease right here, which I have a deep smile line, so we'll see how that performs. I don't really have, I mean, I guess I'll apply some here. I was gonna say I don't have a ton of texture, but I do have pores that I'm seeing on my forehead. Yeah, so you can see it's mattifying, obviously. This side is matte, this side is not. And I definitely missed some spots. So I can see how this product would be great if you don't want to wear makeup, but you still want to perfect your skin a little bit, especially if you have texture, because this does mattify things and therefore diminish the appearance of texture. But it doesn't feel like you have a ton of stuff on your skin. Anyway, so I'm gonna take my foundation, which is gonna be Fenty Beauty Foundation. and I'm going to apply this all over my face, and then we'll be able to do a half face comparison to see just how good this product is. I don't know if it's this foundation, but something smells like really good, and I feel like it's gotta be this foundation. It smells like a knight in shining armor kind of a guy, you know, like the kind that just like has it together. Okay, so this side has the primer stick and this side does not. I'm always expecting, I think, so much from primers, and if I see any poor indication on the prime side, I'm like, the primer doesn't work. But I think I've learned after trying all these primers that you can't have such high hopes for primers. You have to kind of like lower your standards a little bit and just settle for minimizing, not like eliminating. I know they all say minimizing, but I'm always expecting like no pores, and I have to kind of remind myself that primers don't eliminate pores. Usually they at best like minimize them a little bit. So let's just kind of like remember that when we're looking at the skin. I think it looked better without anything on it. I think this is probably the product I would use for the days when I don't want to wear makeup. I see less pores on the side, or maybe they're like less intense. I think forehead looks the same though, but this area definitely looks better. Maybe I just didn't apply enough. Well, hello, we have some creasing going on. I'm gonna run off, finish my makeup, I'm gonna pretty myself up, and I'm going to come back and show you how my face is doing and how this product is making my makeup look. And I'm really hoping that it's gonna do something wonderful and magical while I'm doing my makeup, but we'll see. So stay tuned, and with the magic of editing, I'll be right back. I always have this idea of like transforming myself from one shot to the next, like doing some sort of like a cool sweepy thing and then just like appear and all, you know, glamorous looking, but it never works out because I never have the vision for it. But one of these days I'm gonna like figure out how to do it. All right, you guys, so I am back with my final finished makeup look, and I'm here to give you an update. I'm going to do one more update in a couple hours just to see if this product prevents any creasing, especially in the smile lines. I don't think it will, but we're gonna see. So anyway, let me zoom you in to show you the two sides and just to kind of like give you a closer look at what's going on with my pores and all that stuff. Okay, so this side has the Milk Blur Stick and then this side does not. Let me move to the forehead and then we're just gonna work our way down. As far as the forehead's concerned, I really don't think this side has much difference from this side. So I would say that this really didn't do much there. Now, this area right here is, I think, where I see the most difference. I see a little bit less pores here than I do right here, but I mean by like a slight margin. However, and I don't know if it has anything to do with this product, but I am seeing that my under eye area looks smoother here than it does here. Now, I don't think I applied too much product underneath the eyes, but I know I did go into like this area here. So I'm gonna be really curious to try a little bit more of this like underneath the eyes, like actually full on apply this underneath the eyes. But I am seeing a little bit of a difference here. Like, it just, my skin looks smoother, not necessarily like pore minimized, but more like smoother, better, fresher, healthier. And I don't know if you can really see too much of a difference, but I certainly do. Like right here, my under eyes just look a little bit smoother. As far as the nose, I feel like my nose does look like it has less pores. And as far as any makeup primer that works on like pore minimizing, my nose area is the first one to notice any difference, and I am noticing that my nose looks like it has less pores. I feel like this product makes foundation collect a little bit in the smile line, because like right here you can see there's not like too much stuff collecting. Here you can see there's like a little bit of collection going on, but it's very minor. I don't see too much of a difference. Like, I still have both lines, unfortunately. However, I am going to let it kind of like be for a couple hours, and then I'm going to come back and see how the smile lines are doing. Like, maybe this is going to like really crease in the future and this is just gonna like stay the way it is, which would be perfect, but we're gonna have to see on that. Okay guys, I am doing my final update on the Milk Blur Stick. I look a little bit different because I just filmed another video, so I switched my outfit a little bit, but nonetheless. So I'm just gonna zoom you in to show you my skin. And this side has the product and then this side does not. So
My skin does not look so good today. Just kind of a heads up. It looks really dry because it is, but. All right, and then the forehead. So I think the only thing as far as how it lasts would be whether or not it prevents some of the makeup from creasing. And I actually think it made my makeup crease a tiny bit. I wouldn't say made it crease. I just think that if it's already going to crease somewhere, I don't think it's going to prevent it from creasing any more than it would normally crease. All right, that's a long and weird and strange description, but that's how I'm going to describe it. So I think number one, I would definitely use it if you're looking to have like a no makeup makeup look and you're not looking to apply any like foundation or really any makeup on your skin, but you still want to minimize the pores and just make it look a little bit better. I would definitely use this product in that occasion. And I do think it did something for the pores and for like fine lines, but not as much as I would hope it would do. But what I love about this product is that when you apply it on a skin, it doesn't feel like there's anything on the skin, but it still does something to it. So I also like the fact that it sounds like it's not gonna clog pores. Like it doesn't have dimethicone and oil and silicone, like other things that I would think would be problematic potentially. So I love that about it. This is actually pretty good. I enjoy using this, so thumbs up for it. Not exactly what I expected it, but it's better in some ways. So yeah, thanks so much for watching this video. I hope you found this helpful, and I hope to see you in the next one. Bye.